Howdy and welcome to the San Antonio Fan Association's bridge rally against Proposition A. Defend your family from Proposition A, because crime shouldn't pay. Vote against Proposition A. Don't let criminals get out of jail free. On behalf of the San Antonio Fan Association, we welcome you and join us to learn about how Proposition A is an unjust justice policy, so-called justice policy. Election day is tomorrow, May 6th, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Go to sanantoniofamassociation.com or defendsa.org is easier, defendsa.org. It'll take you to a page with all that information on poll sites and everything. And I want to thank the McLambs for being out here and beginning our time out here on the McCullough Bridge. If you're in the area or close to us, come on out and join us. We're on McCullough Bridge. It crosses over Loop 410. And you can see it's a great location. We got thousands of cars coming by. Awesome. Every couple minutes, probably every 10 minutes, you're going to have 1,000 vehicles coming by. So we're accompanied by Bexar County Sheriff Deputy, Precinct 3 Constable, I should say. Bexar County Precinct 3 Constable, correction. Bexar County Precinct 3 Deputy Constable is out here with us and providing security. So come on out and join us. We're going to have a good time. We're going to be out here until at least 6 p.m. Come join us, because crime shouldn't pay in SA. Vote against Proposition A tomorrow, May 6th, Saturday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Don't let criminals get out of jail free. You can see the Monopoly guy over there, the jailbird. Let's defeat Proposition A, because it will let criminals get out of jail free. We'll talk about that here in just a minute. We'll do a little prayer here and to get us going as we start all of our events. Asking the one triune God to be with us and guide us in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. From 1 Mac 3, verse 19 through 21. It is not the size of the army that victory in battle depends, but strength comes from heaven. They come against us in great pride and lawlessness to destroy us and our wives and our children and to despoil us. But we fight for our lives and our laws. That's exactly what we're doing here today, fighting for our lives and our laws, the very laws that protect us and help people protect them from themselves. A lot of people say, well, if it's legal, it's got to be okay. Well, that's not the case. There's plenty of laws that are immoral. There's plenty of laws that are moral. So this city was founded on morality and on moral laws. This will fundamentally transform San Antonio, the city of San Anthony, to lawlessness and mayhem and chaos. And what happens? Perversion is promoted. Depravity is promoted. Unhealthy lifestyles are promoted. And therefore, the government has to grow to provide for those people who can no longer provide for themselves. This is an attempt to grow socialism, grow the size and scope of government, local government. So let's pray for the one triune God to bless us. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, conscious of our sinfulness, but aware that we gather in your name. Come to us, remain with us, and enlighten our hearts. Give us strength. Give us light and strength to know your will, to make it our own, and to live in our lives. Guide us by your wisdom. Support us by your power. For you are God, sharing the glory of Father and Son. You desire justice for all. Enable us to uphold the rights of others. Do not allow us to be misled by ignorance or corrupted by fear or favor. Unite us to yourself in the bond of love and keep us faithful to all that is true. As we gather in your name, may we temper justice with love so that all our decisions may be pleasing to you and earn the reward promised to good and faithful servants. We ask this of you who live and reign with the Father and the Son, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us remember, it is not the size of the army that victory in battle depends, but strength comes from heaven. They come against us in great pride and lawlessness to destroy us and our wives and our children. and even to disbar us. But we fight for our lives and for our laws. And we ask all these things in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hey, y'all lead us in, Kim, lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. I gotta be able to hear you though. Amen. That's awesome. Great job, Kim. Hey, Betty. We're glad you're watching. It's hot. It's like 99 degrees out here. And thankfully, this sign is providing some shade. So that's pretty cool. And, but Betty, we'd love to have you out here. We even got a chair for you. You're welcome to come join us. Got a chair for you. We'll put you in the shade. Somebody can even drop you off here because we got Bexar County Precinct 3 Constable, Deputy Constable out here with us to help provide security for us. So thanks for watching. Thanks for praying with us and saying the Pledge of Allegiance with us. I'll take a gander at the traffic here that's going on. Getting lots of honks. They see the sign. We're at the 410 of McCullough. The McCullough Bridge. We're at the McCullough Bridge here, and so brought to you on behalf of the San Antonio Family Association. There's the patriotic logo on the side. Walk over here and remind you, Proposition A is an unjust justice policy. Take you over here to the QR code. If you're there, you can go to our website very easily. And at that QR code, put your camera up to your screen. It should take you right to it. Get that QR code, hopefully it works. It works for my camera. I don't know, back up. Yeah! You can see now the Monopoly jailbird getting out of jail free. We don't want that. We need to help hold people accountable, responsible for their actions. And encourage them to be responsible for their actions. So we'll walk back over here now. Get a better view of Augie and Kim in front. And you can hear all the honks, hopefully. Lots of honks coming. Helping keep people awake. We're doing our public service by helping keep people awake on their drive home and facing the sun as they're heading home to keep them safe, keep them awake, paying attention to their driving.
Educate all the passersby. The 2020 Carolina government election day is tomorrow, May 6th. sure that desires and stuff for government to grow, it's bad, not adjustable, maneuver, leave around public safety budgets. Proposition A will decriminalize marijuana possession up to 4 ounces. We're just talking about this lunch. 4 ounces is enough material to make roll.
Number two, voting is proposition A. Cannot say it.
council members, position 8, 9, and 10, those amendments, they all walked the vote. They didn't do anything to represent their constituents. They didn't do anything to do anything except San Antonio. They didn't do anything to defend you. They walked the vote, didn't take a stand at all. And then selfishly say, we can't have anyone to do this vote. Because it's unconstitutional. Lawsuit.
Kim. I got you live. Okay. All right, Augie. I got you live. Tell me what brings you out here today. And you're holding an American flag. What are you doing out here today?
Pretty simple. We don't want San Antonio to become another dirtbag city like San Diego, like San Francisco.
San Diego,
New York
too.
City and Chicago. I left New York City. I was raised in New York City. And let me give you the PG version. New York City, that's all of the time. And we don't want San Antonio to become that. And shame on the pastors who have not spoken out against us. And God bless John Hagee for coming out, being public, and voting against us. He's the only pastor that came out. Shame on the other evangelical pastors.
Well,
we don't want San Antonio to become another San Francisco.
So, back 2 Mondays ago, on April 24th, San Antonio Fan Association, through the Responsible Government Coalition, held a pastor's press conference. I don't know if you're able to watch it or not.
Yep.
We did have some pastors down there.
Yep.
About 15, 17 of them, and they spoke out against it. And so I want to applaud those pastors as well. You can go to sanantoniofanassociation.com/prop and watch that video of those pastors that did it. Obviously, Pastor Hagee did it from his pulpit in a Sunday service. And talking about it, so I commend him for that. And I'm not sure that many other pastors did do that, but I want to give credit to the pastors, the 15 or 18 pastors that came down and joined the Responsible Government Coalition on April 24th at City Hall and spoke out against Proposition A. So go there. You can also go to defendsa.org and watch that video as well, or on social media of San Antonio Family Association. So you lived in New York. You saw what happened there.
Yep.
What do you think will happen here if Proposition A passes?
Well, cops are not going to be able to, just like the proposition says, cops are not going to be able to arrest anyone if they steal up to $750. You're going to have to go into a restaurant and give your credit card before you can purchase anything. Stores are going to close. You can see it all over San Francisco. Places like Chicago, Nordstrom's just closed. Their shops in San Francisco. CVS is pulling out. Walmart's pulling out. Good luck going to find products if all of these businesses just decide to back up because they don't want to conduct business in San Antonio.
Right. Even if they hire security guards, they have their security guards not even stopping the people.
The security guards are not going to want to deal with a liberal DA. Like
Joe Gonzalez, yeah.
They're not going to want to deal with him. He's going to be soft on crime. He'll probably end up prosecuting some of these security guards rather than prosecuting the damn prisoner.
It could certainly go that way. Matter of fact, this whole deal, Proposition A, if it's passed, it'll codify everything that Joe Gonzalez, as district attorney, Bexar County district attorney, is doing in not prosecuting crime. It'll codify him and give him support to his wicked ways in not upholding the law himself. It'll codify and support him.
Yep. And I know a couple of police officers. I don't want to speak to all of them, but it's going to devastate them. They know that allowing somebody to go and deciding and releasing somebody who steals up to $750 is morally wrong, but that's going to be the law of the land. A backdoor way of getting rid of demoralized police officers.
That's right. Well, we don't have enough police officers as it is. We don't have enough police officers as it is, and for a growing city like we are, and we need more police officers as it is, and they need to be supported. And the suicide rate amongst police officers is extremely high, including and especially in San Antonio, and we need to do everything we can to support them. Matter of fact, in 2021, Proposition B, we worked together to defeat Proposition B, which directly defunded police. So we showed support there. This is an indirect way of defunding the police. Because they disguise it by, if Proposition A passes, we're going to have a justice director with the authority of a city manager to redirect public safety funds. And that person can redirect them away from the public safety funds, away from police, and go to San Antonio Metropolitan Health District, or whatever it might be, for mental health, or which is important. But what we need first and foremost are protection of its people. The police are here to protect and serve. We will be handcuffing them, and therefore they won't be able to help us. So thanks very much, Augie, for being out here. You're a gentleman and a scholar, a patriot, along with your wife who doesn't want to be on camera. But we love Kim, and thankfully she's out here. Smile and wave. Hey, y'all, look here. Come back here by the sign. Now you too, back by the sign. Come this way. There you go. Got it. Oh, I got a tea I haven't drank out of.
Huh?
I got a tea I haven't drank out of.
No, I have. It's only one bottle with ice in it.
Okay. Here, I'll hold it. this. Almost out of the sunlight. We go down a little bit. There we go. Now we're out of the sunlight. The camera won't overheat. That's right. Mayor Nuremberg did come out in support of Proposition A in the beginning, and then he flip-flopped and came out against it after political pressure was put on him. Yes, that is correct. That's why we need a super trifecta. You got a super trifecta tomorrow. Exercise your constitutional right, God-given right, and moral obligation to vote. Saturday, May 6th from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Number two, go vote against Proposition A and defend your family. Number three, vote out the incumbent mayor who directly participated and voted for Proposition A to be on the ballot. And the four, number four, super trifecta, vote out your incumbent city councilman. They all participated in directly and making sure Proposition A was on the ballot. It's cost countless hours of time and tens of thousands of dollars, possibly $1 million to fight it. Super trifecta. Exercise your right to vote. Defend your family. And the city needs new leadership for mayor and city council. That's a super trifecta. It'd be a day well spent. It'll take you about 5 minutes to vote. Those three things on the ballot. Get out and vote tomorrow. Take all your family and friends. Make it something objective. Take 12 other people to vote. you're wondering where we are, we're on the McCullough Bridge over 410, Loop 410. So come by and drive by and honk, or come join us. Park. There's plenty of parking on either side of the intersection. We've got Barrett County Constable Precinct 3, Deputy Constable here as security, and it's perfectly safe. Come join us. It's fantastic. So thank you, Mark Bobadich, Barrett County Constable Precinct 3, for sending Deputy Constable over to provide security for us, keep us safe. So come out and join us. You can park at the hotel across on the north side of outside of 410, or just inside. You can park at the bank over here, park the mall. So come out and join us. We're going to be here till 6 p.m. Great opportunity to exercise your patriotic virtue. Come join us. Come join Augie, and come hold the flag for a little bit. It'll be a great time to live out and enjoy the freedom that so many people have fought and died for, who have sacrificed for, and you'll do the same. All right, very cool. We got Ayel McGinty coming to join us in her patriotic colors. Hey, Ayel, what brings you out today? And the safety of your children.
Yes, safety of my children. And, you know, it's not right that they spend money on art projects while not protecting the citizens.
So, yeah. Well, thanks for coming out.
Thank you.
You're a patriot.
Thank you for the sign of all that y'all do at San Antonio Family Association.
Well, you're welcome. Our pleasure. Our pleasure to help defend family. Thank you, Ayel. Back over here. So if you're watching, like Betty Eckert or someone else watching out there, we're on the bridge of McCullough, the McCullough Bridge across Loop 410, just to the east of North Star Mall. Come out and join us if you can. We just had Iowa McGinty come out and join us. And Kim and Augie, myself, Patrick. Come out and join us if you can. We'll be here at least till 6. We've got the Barrett County Precinct 3 Constable office here. And thanks to Mark Vavidich sending out his deputy to provide security for us. And so we're on the bridge. We're safe. And come out and join us. Awesome. Yeah! But one of the reasons why we picked this location is that 1,000 vehicles per 10 minutes come by here. That means 60,000 vehicles in an hour. Hard to see that kind of traffic anywhere else. You can see it in several other places, obviously, but to educate people that there's an election going on and tomorrow is election day, there are thousands of people who don't know there's an election tomorrow. So we have to get out the word to do it, and part of that is education. So education on voting, it's your constitutional right and a moral obligation. You vote against Proposition A to defend your family. Number 3, vote against the incumbent mayor. He participated in putting this unjust justice policy on the ballot as Proposition A. And vote out your incumbent city councilman who all participated in this Proposition A being on the ballot as well. A super trifecta. Be a great patriotic day. Get out and vote tomorrow, Saturday, May 6th, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Go to defendsa.org for information, defendsa.org. Or you can go to the sister organization, TexasFamilyAction.com. TexasFamilyAction.com for a voter guide. Thanks for being with us, and we're going to keep waving, smiling and waving to the 1,000, let's see, that would be more than 1,000 per 10 minutes. So you can find out more information at SanAntonioFamAssociation.com, SanAntonioFamAssociation.com, and on Facebook and Instagram, on Twitter, at Safa Family, S-A-F-A Family. And an easy way to remember it is defendsa.org, defendsa.org.
cars come by, most everybody waving and honking, and four, we're missing four fingers. Request, if you would, somebody come by on 410, brave for traffic, and drive west on 410, and get a picture of us on the McCullough Bridge. If you do that, send it to us, that'd be great, it'd be awesome. Phone number 210-928-7232, that's SAFA's phone number, 210-928-SAFA, S-A-F-A, 210-928-7232. Drive by, take a picture of us up if you would, and text it over to 210-928-7232. San Antonio Family Association's phone, 210-928-SAFA. Thank you. People that are in support of our effort to defeat Proposition A, to vote against Proposition A. So remember, crime shouldn't pay, NSA. Vote against propaganda. Vote against Proposition A. Don't let criminals get out of jail free. And you can see the Monopoly jailbird right there trying to get out of jail free. So I'm going to put it up here where y'all can see the traffic a little bit. And how cool it is to see all these people that are supporting the effort. You stand it back up. I'm gonna show you. Oh,
All right, now. You can see the view that we're seeing as people come by. Traffic's a little bit lighter than it was 30 minutes ago, but you can still see. Watch the people in their front windshield. They're waving and everything.
Finger, but was a thumbs down. But 99.8% have all been 99.9% have all been positive. That's interesting. That person was just waving the peace sign, as in peace be with you. That's exactly what we won't have if Proposition A is passed. We won't have peace because there will be lawlessness. With lawlessness, there's no peace. So the people of goodwill of San Antonio, get out and vote against Proposition A for peace. Peace in your homes, peace on the streets, peace for public safety.
Come on!
a run. Adjust here for a second. Pardon, come over this way. Okay, so what we got? Ione's going to tell us a story that back in December.
Yes.
So in December, she got approached about signing a petition, most likely the justice policy, so-called justice policy petition. So what? Where were you and what happened?
Well, they were down at the Pearl. They were having a Christmas market. You know, Christmas is where we celebrate the birth, the baby Jesus. And this young female came up to me and asked if I wanted to sign a petition to make abortion legal in San Antonio. And it really caught me off guard, but then it really made me mad because I was down there to celebrate the birth of Christ. And so I gave her my opinion that it was murder, and what if Mary had
So did you see her approaching other people?
The words I gave her were so stern. She went down kind of far from me, but I did see her approaching. She had a clipboard.
Was she approaching mostly women?
Yes.
Interesting. She was approaching mostly women, going after trying to get them on the abortion issue,
right,
as if women aren't pro-life.
Right, exactly.
So when does a woman not ever talk about having children someday? Sometimes it's unexpected, especially when you're doing things reserved for marriage. You're participating. Pregnancy can happen, and it's natural. It's not unhealthy. It's not a sickness. It's not a disease.
It's how God designed
this. You're doing what you're designed to do, give life. And interesting that she would target women because she thinks that they would be pro-abortion. And so thank you for being a witness for life, Ione. And God bless you. That's right. We need lots of help, especially tomorrow.
Thank you,
Pastor. Thank you. Are you going to be at a poll tomorrow?
Tomorrow we're celebrating my mother-in-law's 97th birthday.
Oh, fantastic. 97. Wow. Unbelievable. Wow, that's awesome. Be safe. Safe travels. Okay, so show you the sign again. Crime shouldn't pay in SA. Vote against Proposition A. Don't let criminals get out of jail free. It's an unjust justice policy. It's just a nickname. It's not for real. It's virtue signaling. The substance of it is quite the opposite. It's all about injustice. For the individual, for the family, for the business owner, for police and law enforcement, for all public safety. It promotes mayhem, chaos, and lawlessness. And the progressive left, who are all about their sacred cow of abortion, are using it in conjunction with the socialist to grow the size and scope of government, because this will grow the size and scope of government astronomically with a new justice czar. Vote against Proposition A. Election day is tomorrow, Saturday, May 6th, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. You can go to defendsa.org, defendsa.org for more information. I can see. Huh? Almost, yeah. Freedom ring, let the flag wave. Vote against Proposition A. They got smart and put their sunshade up. They didn't roll down the windows yet. I don't know why they wouldn't roll down the windows. At least a couple inches. Here, Jack, get him to honk. Hold this and get him to honk. Just don't stand in front of the sign. Stand like there on the other side of Augie. Get Augie from this way or stand on one side. Yeah, right there in front of the QR code. There you go, right there. The notorious, the infamous Jack M. Finger on site. We can leave now. Turn here, Jack. Turn with your sign. Turn with the sign this way. I can't see you now. Got it. Jack is somebody again. people are on their phone.
Is he taking off?
Yeah.
Good, thank him.
You need help packing up?
No, yeah. No, I'm good.
About that.
Yes.
going to leave tomorrow, Saturday, May 6th, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
The children,
nobody who's not carrying a gun, nobody who's not exercising their constitutional right to defend themselves and carrying a gun on their body. Even then, Proposition A will decriminalize abortion. In the city of San Antonio, will decriminalize marijuana possession for 4 ounces. Will decriminalize theft of $750 per person per incident. Will decriminalize vandalism up to $2,500 per person per incident. Will implement a new justice director's law. Increasing the size and scope of government. Growing it massively. Does that justice director will have to hire employees? And it's going to grow socialism. Besides the stuff of government. The government will intrude and will press down on our individual liberties and freedoms. Don't let that happen. The people who promoted Proposition A are the same who raised their fists back in 2021. They raised their fists in solidarity with the anti-American, anti-life, anti-constitution, anti-public safety, anti-police. They raised their fists against everything we know to be good and right. Those are the same people who put Proposition A on the ballot. Defend the police, defend public safety, defend your personal safety, defend your child, your wife, defend yourself. Vote against Proposition A. Well, thank you for being with us. I'm Patrick Bondo. Saturday, May 6th, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. More information, go to defendsa.org. Defendsa.org. Voter guide, pro-life, pro-family values, voter guide. Go to TexasFamilyAction.com. TexasFamilyAction.com. Proposition A breaks the Ten Commandments. It breaks the Ten Commandments. It breaks the Fifth Commandment. Thou shalt not kill. Breaks the seventh commandment. Exodus chapter 20. Thou shalt not steal. It decriminalizes theft if it's $750 per person per incident. Breaks the eighth commandment. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy. Thou shalt not bear false witness. The eighth commandment of Exodus 20. It allows people to create their own identification, false identification, fake IDs. That can be their proof. No longer a driving license is needed. When you say to Texas, who you are, you can have make a business card. Thou shalt not lie. It breaks the 10th commandment directly. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods. If they, they want your property, they can steal it. Nothing's going to be done to them. Maybe a site and release. That's up to the discretion of the law enforcement officer. SAPD, right? In many cases, nothing's going to happen. If they do, if something does happen, you're going to give them a fake ID. You're going to allow lawful without a half, and the Proposition A passes. If they want your property, they can vandalize it. $2,500 per person per incident. They can vandalize your house of worship. They can vandalize your car, your business, your house. They get away with it. It directly violates, Proposition A directly violates the unjust justice policy. It directly violates and breaks the 5th, 7th, 8th, and 10th Commandments. And I will tell you, because it commands and directs a whole new division of the city of San Antonio to take on a justice director. It will have lots of employees who have to consult with the stakeholders, not the citizens of San Antonio. The stakeholders are the people who put Proposition A forward, who raised their fist against San Antonio, against Texas, against the United States of America, for unlawfulness, for lawlessness. Those same people are considered the stakeholders. The Justice Director will have to consult with them about what happens with people who decided to leave. Bro.
government to hire employees, and the Justice Director can redirect public safety funds from law enforcement, first responders, and everything about crime, Metropolitan Health District. It's already happened in 2020 and 2021. $1.3 million by redirection. From law enforcement, New San Antonio Metropolitan Health District. So, based on that, the scope of government, promoting socialism, and that government's trying to become your God. It's trying to rip God from government. Everything we know to be right and good. The city of San Antonio was established at the seat of faith on June 13, 1691.
Vote against. Vote no. Vote against Proposition A. May God love you.